Louisiana Outdoor Adventures is brought to you by Brian Harris Chevrolet, where our trucks haul bass. It's fall in Plaquemines Parish, and that means two things. The annual pogie migration is on by the tens of millions.
This is one of the biggest pogie fisheries in North America, or Menhaden, where you get all your fish oil from. And this has a lot to do with why this area is so good.
And with that many bait fish in the water comes those who lurk underneath, looking for an easy meal.
That's a good one.
Today on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures, we head out of Venice into West Delta, targeting one of the most tasty fish in the water, the cobia. The annual migration is in full swing, and lemons by the hundreds are piled underneath the buffet of bait. Bouncing from rig to rig is the tactic. Hooking up and looking for friends is the win game.
Yes,
and win,
yes.
We did.
USM, Southern Mississippi, their Gulf Coast Research Lab, they started a cobia tagging program by Dr. Jim Franks. Back then, they did a lot more in-depth research on the cobia. Now, most research is done through a tagging program, which is funded by Sport Fish Restoration. And they really promote anglers, recreational anglers, to go out there, get these tagging kits from the Gulf Coast Research Lab at USM. And when people come out here, if you catch a smaller fish, stick a tag in it. Or if you start catching fish over your limit, start tagging them.
Welcome to Louisiana Outdoor Adventures. I'm Kevin Ford. Or what's left of Kevin Ford after he gets his cobia. We're out in West Delta with Captain Eric Newman. And it's fall. And fall means the run of cobia. And there he is. Woo! Just dropping some jigs. You know, we're about to leave this rig. And when we were about to leave it, we had a hit. Coming up the top of you, Joey. One of the best eating fish in the sea. Now, a lot of times, Eric, what we'll see is we'll see a bunch of them come up with them, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, you know, right now they're in here in such a big aggregation because they're migrating through to head back to Florida. You usually get them in big groups, but this is a little loner. He obviously had a couple buddies with him. We had a couple hits earlier. I lost one, you lost one, but that's a good fish. Oh man, look at them.
They're coming up.
They're coming up, they're right underneath you. Look, I'm gonna try to double up, all right?
Let's do it.
Keep yours in there. See them all? They're kind of deep.
Yeah.
His buddies are being a little bit weird.
All right, we're gonna get this fish here.
Yep. Get us over by the rig, man. And there was, let's see, we'll give it another shot. There was about five of them behind it.
How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Demco Electric. We connect lives.
Well, we have a shrimp boat sitting out here. He's kind of just drifting in this calm water. A lot of times we'll get behind them and see if there's any cobia underneath them. You can throw some chum out or you can just throw your jigs out and see if they come up. But those cobia
will follow these boats until they start picking their catch and throwing the bycatch off.
After 36 years in the business, the product quality and styling is the best that I've ever seen. I'd have to say the number one reason is trust. People do business here at Brian Harris Chevrolet because they trust us. No matter where you shop, no matter what price you might have, I personally commit to save you money on your next Chevrolet.
Hey, before we hit our first fishing hole, our first stop is at a local Cracker Barrel convenience store. They have everything we need. Fuel, ice, drinks, snacks, and more, and even plenty of room at the pumps for your boat. With over 50 locations throughout Louisiana, there is sure to be a locally owned Cracker Barrel location near you. Cracker Barrel convenience stores. We have more than you expect.
Your fishing adventure of a lifetime is just an hour southwest of New Orleans in Houma, Louisiana. From Cocodri, Four Points du Large, Point aux Chiens, we've got it all. Inshore and offshore saltwater fishing at its best. You'll find over 30 charter fishing services, marinas, great restaurants, and abundant accommodations. Experience world-class fishing in the heart of Louisiana's wetlands. Plan your adventure today by visiting www.fishhoma.com. You deserve it.
Lafitte Harbor Marina, located on the C&M Bayou Fuel Dock, is your ticket to some of the best fishing along the Louisiana Gulf Coast. Located just 25 miles from New Orleans, Louisiana, we are a full-service marina offering guided saltwater fishing charters, commercial boat rentals, waterfront lodging, RV parking, fuel, and a well-stocked marine supply and tackle store. Lafitte Harbor Marina is your one stop on your way to good times down on the bayou. Come fish with the best at Team Lafitte Harbor.
Nautic Star's Making Waves is one of the fastest growing names in the boating industry. Quality boats that last and perform. Nautic Star boats are built for fishermen by fishermen. Bay boats from 18 to 24 feet and offshore boats from 20 to 25 feet, Nautic Star builds a boat for you. Compare construction, compare performance, and compare features, and you'll see why Nautic Star blows the competition away. Visit us online at nauticstarboats.com to find a dealer near you. Today's gear is brought to you by Aquamarine and Denham Springs, your Nautic Star, Stratos, and Sea Arc dealer.
You get these bucktail jigs. They come in different head sizes, different weights, different colors. You can use them plain, but the best way to do it is if you get the bucktail and you put one of these curly tails on it, rubber curly tails made by H&H Tackle in Baton Rouge. And it gives it a little tail, more action. You know, a lot of people say they think it's an eel. Other people just think it's the action. You can go different colors. They make white, black, they make oranges, pinks, they make the yellow, which has been effective today. They make green. They do 20 different colors.
The last few days, we had a north wind blowing at 15 to 20. Days before that, we had 15 to 25 mile an hour winds out the east. We were dealing with coastal flood watches and warnings. And look at this, our plan came out perfect today. We were gonna come out with Captain Eric and Mo, and we were gonna come out here and try to tag some of these cobia, and we did it. We could not have had a better day. Woo. I don't know what that is.
It's a big cobia.
It's a big cobia? Man. Oh. Boy, these things, when they hit, they hit.
It's a good one. Walking to the back.
That's a good one. Yeah. This is fun. Oh, look at the cobia behind him.
Let's try to get a double. Let's really try to get some good disaster going on here.
There he is. There's his friend.
Heavy head. I just broke off that big one.
There you go. It's two per person is what you can keep. Mm-hmm. 33 inch aggregate. This one will make the cut.
Yep, it's a good one. His buddy was good too. Too bad Monique tied a bad knot.
Ooh, he's...
Just for record, I didn't tie that knot.
Where is this hook?
We're gonna try to get a couple of these fish in and tag them with a little dart tag. Mo, you got that rig ready? Where's yours?
Right here.
In here.
I think we got him. It's a big cobia.
It's a good fish. We're gonna get a measurement on this fish real quick. We're gonna get from head to fork. 43 inch fish. And then we're gonna get this. This is his, the tag. And that goes in like that. So he's good. Look at those spines. That's what can mess up people in the boat. The spines on his back. We'll go over that on another fish that we kill. Let's make sure he lives.
It's a pretty fish.
There he goes.
There he goes. Awesome. Well, that was fun.
That was good stuff. Yeah.
Let me tell you something though. You were terrible with that.
The Boca grip?
The Boca grip.
Yeah.
Did you do it on purpose?
No, I didn't. But it, now that it happened, I'm going to do it all day long on you.
I can tell you one thing. Glad you weren't tagging me, because if you were tagging me, I'm done. I'd have floated right up to the top. Put a tag in me right now. You know, catching the cobia is one thing, but when you see those cobia come up and follow the fish that's hooked, that's just an unbelievable adrenaline rush. You've got to come down here to Plaquemines Parish in the fall and do this. It is something you'll never forget.
Oh yeah, man. It's a good one. I mean, dude, you may be the cobia whisperer.
The good thing about this is you can use relatively light tackle.
He might be a little smaller than the last one. And he
still
is
still a good fish.
Yeah, he's a good fish. He's solo though, so I'm gonna put this up.
These things are so fun to catch.
He's definitely.
Golly, he isn't. They don't look that big until they get to the side of the boat.
Oh yeah, that's a good one. That's a real good one. I got it. That's actually about a. That's a real good fish. Work your way around. Work your way around the boat. There you go.
Sorry about that, guys.
There you go. You good? That's actually probably bigger than the last one.
Got it.
He spun out. No, I did that on purpose.
Yeah.
I can't let you know, totally conquer this fish.
I don't know who's conquering who at this point, boys.
Yeah, I think. All right.
That's a fish.
Yeah, that's about a 50 pounder. One. As you can see on these fish, this is their this is about their main weapon when you get them in the boat. It's got these real spiny dorsals. These are solid bone. And this is the problem. When they come in and they start rolling like that fish did when we gaffed it, this can really cut you up. I've seen guys get a lot of stitches from these fellas right here. They're real thick. Got a real broad tail. They got big pecs. This is a highly migratory species. This is a pelagic, and they're built for power. This fish is designed for a lot of power. They cover a lot of ground. He likes feeding on the bottom. You know, they eat a lot of crabs, eels, a lot of bottom fish. They'll eat a lot of hardhead catfish at times.
Coming up, the action gets hotter as the boat gets surrounded by cobia. Can Captain Eric pull the perfect cast with a fly? Professional anglers worldwide consider Plaquemines Parish the premier fishing destination in North America. The mighty Mississippi River provides the source for the greatest habitats for fresh and saltwater fishing imaginable. 10 marinas, abundant lodging, great local restaurants, along with friendly people guarantee you the fishing trip of a lifetime. You can fish anywhere, but you catch fish in Plaquemines Parish. Visit our website at www.plaquemines.com for all of the details. Plaquemines Parish, it's catching. Regardless of the fishery, the pursuit is still the same. The strike, the hookup, and the realization that you do still have a pulse. Find it with Akuma. Leading an industry in innovative design and advanced technology, Akuma Fishing Tackle is home to the most exciting equipment available. The revolutionary Makaira, Cedros Reels and Rods, all new Citrix Bass Rods and Reels, Andros 2-Speed Reels and Jig Rods, Trio Crossover Spinning Reels, Billfish to Bass, Tuna to Trout. There is no stopping Akuma.
Miralure, the right tools to catch them.
There he is. Oh, baby. Oh, yeah.
Turn on the bite anytime. Tie on a Miralure.
The best fishermen know that Venice, Louisiana is the place where you catch fish, and Lighthouse Lodge and Villas is located just minutes from Venice's marinas. Stay at Lighthouse Lodge and enjoy our brand new Bahamas-style rooms with all the comforts like satellite TV, Wi-Fi, refrigerators, and microwaves. Or stay in our condo-style villas and choose to have your own kitchen and room for the family. Either way, our staff is here to make your stay in Venice a great one. Escape to Sportsman's Paradise at Lighthouse Lodge and Villas. Toughline is the leader in high-performance premium braided fishing line. Compact, small in diameter, longer cast, higher abrasion resistance, and zero shedding separates Toughline from the rest. Ask for Toughline today at your local tackle dealer.
Think all jig heads are the same? They're not. With its unique rattle chamber, the Rockport Rattler is literally a dinner bell for fish. So unique, it was awarded a U.S. patent. The light-reflecting eyes work well in both clear and muddy water, and colors and sizes separates the Rockport Rattler from the rest. The Rockport Rattler works for both salt and freshwater species. Just add your favorite soft plastic, cast, and tell the fish it's supper time. The Rockport Rattler, a jig head that fish can hear, available at tackle stores near you or online at www.rockportrattler.com.
Today's game plan was to just start off in 30 or 40 feet of water, start hitting every satellite rig and bigger rig, and just work from rig to rig, give it a couple minutes, see if you have any hookups and mark anything on the bottom finder.
I got him out.
Let me get a backup rod in case
he's got a. Now you got big aggregations of these 40 plus pound fish, so it's definitely prime time right now.
He got a big one, he is a big one.
And it'll be like this all the way from Venice all the way into, you know, way into South Timbaleer.
Thanks, Mo. Help me drag him out.
In that 30 to 40 foot range seems to be the magic number.
I bet he's hooked, dude. That hook just shifted in him.
The cobia are very curious fish. I mean, some anglers, when they get next to the rig, they'll slap the side of the boat, they'll start splashing their rod tip in the water. They always follow up the fish you have hooked, a lot like mahi-mahi. You know, whenever you hook a mahi, he's always got his little school buddies with him. Cobia do the same thing, and I don't know if it's a kind of a schooling pack thing they do or if it's out of curiosity. I think it has a lot to do with curiosity.
Hold on. We got cobia everywhere.
Mo's on.
Did you see the school?
Yeah. Oh,
yeah.
I'm watching.
We're about to have a triple.
Kevin, can you
got it!
A triple!
That's what I'm talking about.
A triple! Here's the only problem with this whole deal. Guess who's driving the boat?
We work my way around the boat.
We got three fish on in the boat right now. Here.
Y'all got to get video. I got to see this. Mo, you got to wait. We're going to watch Kevin. We're going to watch Ford get totally messed up.
He could go overboard
with this. Where do you gaff him at?
Right in the side.
In the side?
Yeah.
Hit him hard. No, don't lie.
Hey, no, no, it's all, you got it. When you hit him, you got to hit him hard, and he's gonna have to back up.
All right. All right, we got him. One down. Now we got one on the fly rod in the back.
John hooked up a fish, and when he was pulling the fish up,
look at the size of that one. Oh, that's your fish.
Yeah. When John hooked that fish up, I guess, how many came up with him?
About 10.
About 10 of them came up with him. Monique threw a jig out, and she hooked up blind on it. She was just jigging it, hooked up blindly. When the fish came up, John had one following his, and I grabbed the fly rod and threw this fly in front of it, and he sucked it up pretty good. Well, I mean, if you're going with, like, IGFA, you're gonna go real light on your tippet, so that's where you break it, but I got, like, a 30-pound tippet, and like a 60-pound shock leader, so I can put a good bit of heat on this fish.
It's awesome. I mean, to get these cobia on the surface like that and then start being able to pitch in flies or other plugs, it's really cool. And you can throw anything at them. I mean, I've tried all kind of stuff. They get very aggressive when they come up with the other one you have hooked. And it's a good time.
We are going to get this fish that Eric caught in the boat. We're going to try to get it tagged real quick and get her back released again.
40 inches, we get the tag, we're going to pop it in right there. I'm going to get this guy.
And he's going.
That fish is good. That fish is alive.
Today's outdoor product is brought to you by Buoy Outfitters, everything outdoors. One thing is for sure about offshore rods and fighting these kinds of fish. Tomorrow morning, you are going to have a bruise from the rod butt firmly planted in your stomach. Well, Old Harbor Outfitters has solved that problem with a combo tech short sporting sewn-in buckles accompanied by a snap-on fighting belt. So no more looking around the boat for a belt when that fish hits. You can simply hook up and wear this lightweight belt, and it's always there when you need it. You can find all items featured in today's show at Buoy Outfitters on Perkins.
After 36 years in the business, the product quality and styling is the best that I've ever seen. I'd have to say the number one reason is trust. People do business here at Brian Harris Chevrolet because they trust us. No matter where you shop, no matter what price you might have, I personally commit to save you money on your next Chevrolet.
C&M Bayou Fuel Dock and Boat Rentals in Lafitte has work boats from 19 to 36 feet, and we deliver anywhere and anytime. C&M also has TransCube fuel transportation tank rentals up to 1,240 gallons. Our ship store is fully stocked with the supplies you need to get the job done. Batteries, oil, marine paint, rope, pumps, and more. It's all at C&M Bayou Fuel in Lafitte. Visit us online at bayoufuel.com and cnmboatrentals.com today, or call us at 504-689-2013.
Since April of 2010, more than 2,300 seafood samples from waters off Louisiana's coast have been tested by dedicated citizens for safety. Now you can access all of those results on a public website called gulfsource.org. Search by sample type, location, and more. Get the facts about fresh, delicious Louisiana seafood. You be the judge, we'll be the source. Visit us at GulfSource.org.
Out of the swamps of South Louisiana comes one of the finest fishing destinations in the world, Cypress Cove Marina and Lodge in Venice. Our lodge offers 61 newly remodeled rooms with free Wi-Fi and a ship store with all of the supplies you need for a day on the water. Cypress Cove Marina also features a dry stack storage facility, 8 fuel pumps, a 3-lane back down launch, and fish cleaning station. From bass to blue marlin, come to Cypress Cove in Venice, where your dreams become a reality.
Fishing. It's where good stories come from. It's about good times and family and friends. It's about taking a couple home for dinner tonight and saving a few for tomorrow. It's all about that and so much more. To CCA, fishing is about enjoying today and making sure tomorrow is even better. To us, fishing comes with a responsibility for the resources we enjoy so much. If fishing means all that to you, then you belong with CCA.
This segment of Louisiana Outdoor Adventures is brought to you by Wilco. Where there are no roads, all roads lead to Wilco.
Purse is a monster. I usually fish the smaller structure, so any rig, 30, 40 feet, any kind of structure for these fish to hide on.
Yep, friends.
And make sure you bring a lot of jigs, because as, like today, there'll be a lot of Spanish, king mackerel, and bluefish. We burnt through maybe 20 lures.
I got him! There he is! Oh, he popped off. There's
Johnny! Cast your bait out. It broke off?
Yeah.
I mean, that's a big something. If I can get him to slow down enough, I'm gonna stick him with the tag, and then I can try to get a measurement.
In the meantime, we got Joey, or we got the tag.
Tag's in.
Look at Joey's fish a minute. I said 4 feet.
46 inches, tail to four, tip to four.
And he is gonna go back and hopefully, hang on, be healthy.
He's fine, he swam out.
Great day, buddy. Captain Eric Newman with the Louisiana Department of Wildlife and Fisheries. This was incredible. These lemon fish out here in the fall, I mean, people would die just to catch two or three of these things. We went out here today, heck, we missed 15 of them, huh?
Oh, I lost five in a row.
It was amazing. Hey, we hope you enjoyed it as much as we enjoyed bringing it to you right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures. It was a great time. Come fish Plaquemines Parish whenever you can. For producer John Jackson and videographer Joey Bordelon, I'm Kevin Ford. Come fish Louisiana. We'll see you next week on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures.